There is a great pleasure when you unlock your bootloader, install custom recovery, and then you're able to flash a custom ROM. And, you know, possibly after doing that, you flash Google apps and you reboot the phone and it reboots into this new custom ROM. Now, it's always interesting, but if you are using an on-screen fingerprint, like I'm doing this with Realme X2, there is a problem of sometimes registering fingerprint. Now, I'm going to show you secrets of how to do that easily, you know. So, as you're doing it now, you come at a place, you get that red line warning that can't read fingerprint, and sometimes it repeats and repeats, and people like get tired. I've got a lot of that comment in the channel here. So, I'm going to show you how you can easily record fingerprints in any custom ROM without stress. So let's see. Welcome back to Smart Depot. If you like this video, just click on that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell icon to get more videos and notification when we put out new videos. So the first thing that you're going to be aware of is touch sensitivity. The touch sensitivity is very, very important for custom ROMs that use custom, you know, kernels or whatever they're using. It's light. You just have to touch it very light. I'm going to show you that because this screen is flashing. I'm going to use an on-screen recording to show you that clearly. Then the next thing also you're going to notice is the position. There are two circles when that light flashes, the wider one and the smaller one. So you got to make sure that your hand is inside the smaller one. So I'm going to go in now to screen record and show you. So now after recording this fingerprint, it's so easy. So watch it now. You see the circle now? There is a wider circle of light and a smaller circle of light. So your touch has to be inside, completely inside that smaller circle. Are you seeing it now? So I'm using a screen recorder right now so you can feel my touch very well. So as every time I try, the fingerprint opened without stress. I'm probably using a Colt OS on this one. So it amazes me sometimes why people are actually worried that they can't use the fingerprint on a custom ROM, especially in Realme X2 and some other on-screen fingerprint devices. So as you can see it now, it's opening. I can do this all day long. I can like do it all day long. So I'm going to go into the setting right now and I'm going to go register a new fingerprint and I'm going to show you the secrets. Very simple. So the first one you have to learn is that the touch has to be very light. It's so light sometimes I so much enjoy it. If it is too strong, the fingerprint might not register. So the next one is the positioning. Now the positioning have to be inside that circle. Now I'm going to give you the third secret, which is very, very important. So if you keep touching the screen, if you go outside the position, it will tell you fingerprints or move fast. It will just give you a warning. But if you keep touching the same place, the same way after 2-3 times, the fingerprint reader will reject it. Now this is what many people don't understand. The fingerprint reader will reject it. So you have to shift your hand a little with that light touch, a little to the left, a little to the right. Make sure that you cover wider areas of your finger. So you tap it, you shift your finger a little bit, you tap it light, shift your finger a little bit. If you have any issue, just wipe your hand with soft cotton and then probably wipe the screen with soft cotton if you feel that so much oil is on the screen. So if you keep tapping it like that lightly and make sure you shift different places, it will automatically record the fingerprint. So it's that easy. I'm telling you, I use the stock where I have to press it harder, but this one is so sweet. A little just light touch and bam, it opens. It just opens so quickly. So I'm going to try to replicate a common error by touching the same place 3 times. And when I do that, it's going to say leave fingerprint and touch again. So it also happens when you are registering fingerprint that you go a little bit off the circle. You go a little bit off that smaller circle. If you go a little bit off it while it's still reading there, it will still give you the error as in lift up finger and touch again. So those are the two basic things you're going to watch out for. So while you're tapping, make sure you are covering wider areas of your fingerprints. Remember, if you tap the same place like 3 times, it will request you lift finger and touch again. It's not an error, you just want you to, you know, cover wider area of your fingerprint. So, and as you're covering wider area of your fingerprint, gentle touch and then shifting it, it's also important that you stay within the smaller circle. As you can see, I've registered 3 fingerprints and all of them are so easy. Just tap it, it opens, close, open. It's just so print ready. registered here. If you tap it, it's so sweet. Except you now start moving outside that circle. If you move outside that circle, you might have a problem that fingerprint, you know, didn't record well. But if you keep it in that circle, that smaller circle, and keep tapping it, you will have it. So make sure you subscribe, drop your comment in the comment section, and then check out some of that ROM that we've done the review. And I'll see you in the next video. So wherever you are, stay safe, and until we'll see you next time, peace out. I see you.